So here's a truss with some complexity. And the problem is asking for the forces in the following members. The problem gives us some dimensions and it looks like it's symmetrical here. This should help. The first thing to do in trusses is always solve for external forces by summing moments about a point. Summing moments about point A will create an equation that looks like the following. Point E will have a reaction of 146 pounds. Now summing forces in the y direction will find point A's reaction. So now that the reaction has been found, we can begin using method of sections. Generally, making a cut that has 3 unknowns or less is the ideal use of this method. You usually want your unknowns to be forces of interest. BC, BG, and HG will make perfect candidates to cut straight through. After making the cut, deciding which side of the truss to drop off is the next step. It's usually preferred to keep the side with less external forces. Next is replacing those cut members with external forces as well. These will represent the force in the member itself. Now the thing that is so special about this method is that we can reference concurrent points that may not be on the section. It's also possible to use geometry to create other points for reference, but we won't worry about that right now. The key concept of method of sections is summing moments about a point that will eliminate all the unknowns besides one. Here, you want to look for a force's line of action to see where it'll have no lever arm. Summing moments about point G eliminates 2 unknowns, making it possible to find BC. The equation will look like this, and BC equals negative 116.8 pounds. All the negative means is that the force is drawn in the wrong direction, and it should be flipped. This force is pushing onto member BC, so it's compressing the member. That way of thinking makes it easier to identify members in compression or tension. Now we need a new point. Point H appears to give member HG no lever arm, leaving us with BG as an unknown. Now the perpendicular distance of the line of action of force BG can be figured out by geometry, or the force BG can be replaced by its components as well. When dealing with these forces that are diagonal, you're able to move the force along its line of action to a preferred point where one of the components drops from the moment equation. When force BG is near point B, force BGY has its line of action very near point H, and force BGX is very near point B, so it has a lever arm of 18 feet. To solve directly for force BG, ratios would be a great use here. Relate the forces to the geometry of member BG. Substitute for BGX and solve for force BG. The force is positive, which means that the direction of the vector is correct. The force is pointing on the member, so the member is in tension. Now to find force HG, we could sum almost about another point. But let's sum forces to see how it works. First, compute the components of force BG. Then replace force HG with its components and sum forces in the x direction. Solve for HGX. Now you can use ratios here to solve for both HGY and HG. Check your answers for equilibrium. This free body diagram is now complete. Two more forces are fine. But let's take a look at C first. Draw a cut line for the section of interest. Curved lines are okay. Add force vectors representing the forces applied to the members. We know member BC is in compression. And the other two forces are found from the equations of equilibrium. So CD must be in compression as well to counter BC in this free body diagram. But what about CG? There's no other force to counter it at this joint. So this is telling us that it can't have a force applied to it. This type of member is called a zero force member. So let's look at the members we know so far. It looks like member GD is the only remaining member to solve for. This section could do it, but let's try a more challenging approach. Try isolating the members attached to joint G. Draw the free body diagram and add forces. Assume GD and GF are in tension. If these are in compression, the solution will be negative. Replace these forces with X and Y components. And apply the laws of equilibrium. It looks like two equations with four unknowns. But substitutions can be made using ratios as well. Now there are two equations with two unknowns. Some algebra here. Solving GF will allow a substitution into the above equation. Both GF and GD are positive, telling us the forces are in the correct direction. Check the answers. That wraps up this free body diagram. And it wraps up this problem too.